So students, let's continue with our chapter acids, bases and salts. As we have completed with acids and bases, so today we will study about salts. Now how we will define salt. What is a salt? A salt is a combination of an anion of an acid and a cation of a base. For example, if we taken the simple example of sodium chloride or common salt, in it HCl plus NaOH give rise to NaCl. We will very well known in that reaction. We have already done it in neutralization reaction. So HCl in NaCl, that Cl part, that is, it is the anion of the acid. Acid is made up with one cation and one anion, H positive and Cl negative. So that Cl negative, it is the Cl negative, it is the anion part of the acid. So in salt, anion part of the acid comes from the acid, and for base the cation part is come. So salt is the combination of an anion of acid and a cation of a base. For example, KCl, NaNO3, CaSO4, etc. All these are the salts. Then salts are usually prepared by the neutralization reaction of an acid and a base. This we have already done in neutralization reaction. One most common example is of common salt, that is sodium chloride, which is referred to as common salt because it is used all over the world for cooking. In this, we also have to study family of salts. See, if salts having the same cation or anion belong to the same family, means in salt, if all these are having the same cation or anion, it belongs to the same family. For example, NaCl, KCl, LiCl, all these belong to the same family because all these are having same anion, Cl negative. Then next is NaOH, it is also known as caustic soda. Now next is pH of salts. How we will detect the pH of a salt? If a salt of a strong acid and a strong base will be neutral in nature, if the acid is strong and the base is also strong, then the salt will formed is neutral in nature. So it is having pH approximately 7, because 7 is for neutral. We have already done in the pH. Then a salt of a weak acid and a strong base will be basic in nature, because in this the acid is weak and base is strong. So the salt that is formed will be basic in nature. So it must have the pH greater than 7. Then if a salt of a strong acid and a weak base, now the salt is having, means a salt that is formed from the strong acid and a weak base, obviously it is acidic in nature and it is also having pH less than 7, because on the pH meter below 7 are acidic and above 7 are basic in nature. Then the pH of a salt of a weak acid and a weak base, now the salt from which is formed from a weak acid and a weak base, that will determine by conducting a pH test. For that salts, we have to conduct a pH test to determine their pH. This is all about pH of salts. Now in this chapter, we have to study 5 basic salts, that is common salt, NaCl, sodium chloride, bleaching powder, baking soda, washing soda and POP, that is plaster of Paris. Only these 5 salts we have to study in detail in our chapter. Now first is common salt, that is sodium chloride. Formula is NaCl. We have already studied in the neutralization reaction that salt is formed by the combination of hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide, means HCl plus NaOH. which give rise to NaCl plus water. So it is the basic, or if you can say that, formation reaction of the common salt. Now this is the salt that you use in your food. We also know that sea water contains many salts dissolved in it. So sodium chloride is separated from these salts. Then deposits of solid salt are also found in several parts of the world. These large crystals are often brown, which is due to impurities. This is also called rock salt. Now beds of rock salt were formed when seas of bygone ages dry up. Rock salt is mainly mined like coal. As you have also studied in your social science, or you have must have heard about Mahatma Gandhi's Dandi March. Did you know that the sodium chloride was such an important symbol in our struggle for freedom? Now that sodium chloride, which is obtained, is an important raw material for various materials of daily use, such as sodium hydroxide, baking soda, washing soda, bleaching powder. For all these salts, this common salt or sodium chloride plays an important raw material role. So let's see how one substance is used for making all these different substances. So first, sodium hydroxide. Now how this sodium hydroxide will be formed through this sodium chloride? See here one picture is given to you. It is a chloralkali process which is shown to you. In this, when electricity is passed through an aqueous solution of sodium chloride, we call that aqueous solution of sodium chloride is known as brine. It decomposes to form sodium hydroxide. See the reaction. When electricity is passed through that NaCl, it will decompose into NaOH and chlorine gas will be evaluated. Then the process is called chloralkali process, because the products formed chlor for chlorine and alkali for sodium hydroxide. That's why we call it as chloralkali process. Now see in this picture that chlorine gas is given off at the anode and hydrogen gas at the cathode. Sodium hydroxide solution is formed near the cathode. So the three products produced in this process are all useful. See different uses of these products. That hydrogen, which is used as fuels, margarine or ammonia for fertilizers, and chlorine, which is used as water treatment or in swimming pools, in PVCs, disinfectants, CFCs, chlorofluorocarbons or pesticides. That chlorine is used in all these. And sodium hydroxide, it is used as degreasing metals, used for degreasing metals, soaps and detergents, also in paper making, artificial fibers. So both these H2 and Cl2, this will make hydrochloric acid, this will again make hydrochloric acid, and which is again used for cleaning steel, ammonium chloride, medicines, cosmetics. And that chlorine with that of NaOH, it is used as for bleaching agent, for example in household bleaches or for the bleaching fabric. So these are the important products from the chloralkali process, and all these are useful in our daily life. Now our next important salt is bleaching powder. Chemical name of this salt is calcium oxychloride. Now we have already done that chloralkali process. In that process, chlorine is produced during the electrolysis of aqueous sodium chloride, that is brine. So this chlorine gas is used for the manufacture of bleaching powder. That bleaching powder is produced by the action of chlorine on dry slaked lime. I have already tell you what is slaked lime, CaOH ka whole twice. When we will treat this slaked lime with chlorine gas, then it will form bleaching powder, calcium oxychloride along with the water. So this is the reaction for the formation of this bleaching powder. Its chemical formula is CaOCl2. Now what are the uses of this bleaching powder? First, it is used for bleaching cotton and linen in the textile industry. Mainly bleaching powder to use for bleaching cotton and linen, and also for bleaching wood pulp in the paper factories and for bleaching washed clothes in the laundry. So second use, it is also used as an oxidizing agent in many chemical industries and for disinfecting drinking water to make it free of germs. So these are the basic uses of this bleaching powder. Third important salt is baking soda, that is sodium bicarbonate. Now its chemical formula is NaHCO3. That soda, the commonly used in the kitchen for making tasty crispy pakoras, is the baking soda. Your mother will use it in the kitchen. Sometimes it is also added for the faster cooking. So the chemical name of that baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate, that is NaHCO3. The chemical name of the compound is sodium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, it is produced by using sodium chloride as one of the raw materials. Now how will it will be produced? It is produced on a large scale by treating cold and concentrated sodium chloride, that is again brine, with ammonia and carbon dioxide. So it will produce ammonium chloride and sodium hydrogen carbonate, or you can say that sodium bicarbonate, one of the same thing. You can also say it as sodium hydrogen carbonate or sodium bicarbonate. Now when this on heating, it decomposes to give sodium carbonate with the evolution of carbon dioxide. So if we heat this sodium bicarbonate, it will give sodium carbonate and along with the evolution of carbon dioxide. Now what are the uses of this sodium hydrogen carbonate? First, it is used as an antacid. It is used as an antacid because it is being alkaline, so it neutralizes the excess acid in the stomach and provides us relief. Second, it also used for making baking powder, which is a mixture of baking soda and mild edible acid, which is tartaric acid. So when baking powder is heated or mixed in water, it will form carbon dioxide. So these are mainly used in the preparation of bread or cakes to rise, making them soft and spongy. So that carbon dioxide which is released, that carbon dioxide will make it soft and spongy. Now it is also used in the soda acid fire extinguishers. So it is also used in the fire extinguishers. So these are the basic uses of baking soda, sodium bicarbonate.